Not long ago, a customer sent this target in, and he's talking about his scope being defective. Here's the sequence of shots according to the customer. This was his first shot. He was aiming right here. This was his first shot. So he fired four more. And this would be his second shot, his third shot, his fourth shot over here is a bit of a flyer, but maybe not. And then this is his fifth shot. Well, assuming that this was his true group, he adjusted about 2 minutes of angle down to bring this down to this height. Then he fired his sixth shot, and the sixth shot ended up down here. At this point, he's totally frustrated with the whole process. He's pretty sure the rifle's in good shape because of this, and it probably is. But it was not the scope. Because I can duplicate this error, and I'm pretty sure I know exactly what happened. Owning a rifle range and seeing people do this hundreds of times, it's a common, very common error. Our shooter's problem was not with his scope or with his rifle, it was the process he used zeroing the rifle. He undoubtedly rested the rifle on the forearm of the rifle rest and fired his first shot, which is exactly what I did, and my shot went here. Which simulates very well with what he had on his target. Then I moved the rifle back so that it rests on the barrel. And I fired four more shots, and the group went up here. I'd made no scope adjustments. The pressure on the barrel actually moves the group up more than you'd think. So this being a very good group here, as well as it was on his target, he made a 2 minute of angle adjustment, which I did. This is the first and only adjustment I made, was 2 minutes of angle. And that should have, in his mind, brought the scope group back down to here. When he put the rifle back on the rest, he put it on the forearm again, as he should have. Sixth shot went 2 minutes of angle low, right down here, as mine did, 2.226 inches difference. Okay, first shot. Good, now, four more shots. All of which I think our shooter took from a position like this. Okay, I made no sight changes, but I am resting it on the barrel. Get comfortable here. Four shots. What I think the individual did was he put on 2 MOA, he brought it down 2 MOA to match that, which I'm going to do, but he went back to shooting like this. Probably going to go low, 2 minutes, and it does. Bottom line is, always rest the rifle on the forearm, not the barrel. This is wrong, this is right. I don't care if you use a homemade rifle rest such as this one or a commercial one. Sandbags, a jacket rolled up over the hood, always rest it on the forearm. Now if you're going to wrap this barrel in tape or cord or whatever to make it camoed or whatever you think is cool, anytime you put pressure on this barrel, down, up, left, right, it's going to move that bullet group one direction or the other.
try and keep the barrel floated if you can. Now, if you have a rifle that's not floated, and it gets and it or hot, cold, wet, whatever, and it warps, it's going to push that group one direction or another. So if you can, get your barrel floated. Don't mess around with it so that it makes contact with anything it does not need to make contact with. That's about it. Hope this helps you. If you like it, good. Subscribe. If you don't, well, like always, you can watch somebody else. Thanks.